गुड आफ्टरनून चिल्ड्रन.
गुड आफ्टरनून मैम.
सो इन द लास्ट क्लास वी आर डिस्कसिंग प्रॉब्लम्स बेस्ड ऑन सिमिलैरिटी. ओके इट्स ओके सिमिलैरिटी ऑफ ट्रायंगल्स. ओके व्हाट आर द क्राइटेरियाज वी हैव लर्नड फॉर सिमिलैरिटी. हाउ मेनी क्राइटेरियाज आर देयर एंड व्हिच आर द क्राइटेरियाज.
Five criterias.
For similarity, is it five?
Three.
You copied that notes, okay? Similarity criteria, which one I have sent? Did you copy it? SAS. SSS.
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 AAA.
AAA criteria or AA criteria. Okay, AAA criteria or AA. Nowadays, we are using only AA criteria. What about the second one? SSS. All the sides are similar. All the sides are proportional, means they are similar. Third one is SAS. Two sides and the included angle. Two sides and the included angle. Okay. Hope you have copied the questions that I sent yesterday. Is or no? Copied the questions? Yes, children, look at this question. Look at the question here. In the given figure, okay, in the given figure, triangle ABE is what is the symbol given here? Is it similar or congruent?
Congruent.
Congruent to ACD. Show that ADE is similar to triangle ABC. Think again. Okay. Children, did you copy the questions? Which one I have sent yesterday? You copy it,
yes,
so we can do it again. So, okay, yesterday's question. It is the question number 6 from the NCERT textbook. Question number 6. In the given figure, triangle ABE is congruent to triangle ACD. You have to prove triangle ADE is similar to triangle ABC. Okay. So what is given here? It is given triangle ABE is congruent to triangle ACD. We have to prove triangle ADE is similar to triangle ABC. Okay, I'll redraw the figure once again. Okay, so this is the figure given. A, B, C, B, E. B, E is the figure given. So now look at this. It is given A, B, E and A, C, D are congruent. A, B, E. So we join these two. These two are congruent. We have to prove triangle A, D, E is similar to triangle ABC. Here in this question, no angle is given, isn't it? We are not given with the angle. So we can't go with AA criteria. Is it clear? We have three criteria. Here we will not be able to use AA criteria because angle is not given. Now look at this. It is given triangle ABE is similar to triangle ACD. You start with the given condition. It is given triangle ABE is congruent. If it is congruent, what we know? If it is congruent, can we say AB will be equal to AC, corresponding parts CPCE.
Yes, ma'am.
First two, if you take the first two letters, that is first side AB will be same as side AC, side BE will be same as side CD, and AE will be same as AD. Also, we will get the angles are also equal. We will get angles are also equal. So this is by CPCT. What is CPCT? Corresponding parts of congruent triangle. Corresponding parts of congruent triangle. Now look at the result you want to prove. What is the result we want to prove? We have to prove ADE. Okay. We want to prove ADE. ADE means this is the triangle, the smaller triangle and the big triangle. ADE is the smaller triangle, is similar to triangle, is similar to the triangle, the big triangle, ABC. The smaller triangle, this smaller triangle and the big triangle are similar. Now look at this figure. Okay, we want to prove this big triangle and smaller triangle are similar. If you look in these two triangles, the smaller and bigger, compare it and look at their triangles and tell me which angle is common. Are you getting any angle common there?
Angle A.
Angle A, isn't it? Okay, we want A, B, E, A, D, E. We want A, D, E. A, D, E is the smaller triangle. And the bigger triangle is ABC. Okay, these are the two triangles A, D, E, and ABC. We want to prove these two are similar. If you look in these two figures, which angle is common? Angle A, is it common?
Yes, ma'am.
So one angle we are getting as common, isn't it? B, E, and B, E are not common. What about the sides? Is it possible to prove sides are proportional? Check it with the given condition. We are given with CPCT. Three conditions are given. Three conditions are given. Use the CPCT of that. When you use the CPCT, whether you will get the results. Okay, so I'm considering the two triangles. Which are the two triangles we consider? Consider ADE and triangle ABC. In these two triangles, angle A is equal to angle A. It is common. Angle A is common. Then look at the CPCT. AB is equal to AC. Yes or no? Is it given AB is equal to AC? These two sides are equal. And whether it is given AD is equal to AE? So it is given AD is equal to AE. AD is equal to AE and AB is AD is equal to AE. Second, here it is. AD is equal to AE and we have AB also equal to AC. Is it there by CPCT? Is it given? In yes. CPCT, AD is equal to AE and AB is equal to AC. So these are equal numbers. When we divide these two numbers, equal numbers, whether they will be equal? These two are equal.
Yes, ma'am.
AD is equal to AE, AB is equal to AC. Therefore, can we say AD by AB will be equal to AE by AC?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes or no? These two numbers are equal. These two numbers are equal.
So
when you divide it, if you divide that numbers, the ratios will be equal. Okay. So therefore, AD by AB is equal to AE by AC. So now we have one included angle is equal and the sides are proportional. included angle is equal and the sides are proportional. Therefore, by SAS criteria, which criteria we are using here? SAS, because one angle is equal and the sides are proportional. Therefore, by SAS criteria, we get triangle ADE is similar to triangle ABC. Triangle ADE is similar to triangle ABC. Hence, proved. ADE is similar to triangle ABC. Okay, from the given, it is congruent. Two triangles are congruent means all the sides are equal and all the angles will be, that is corresponding sides, not all the sides, corresponding sides will be equal and the corresponding angles are also equal. We use the CPCT criteria here. It is congruent. Therefore, corresponding parts of congruent triangles are equal. We want to prove these two triangles are similar. If you look in that two triangles, we get angle A as common and the sides by CPCT, they are equal. So if you divide these two equal numbers, they will be in proportion. So included angle and the sides are proportional. Therefore, by SAS criteria, they are similar. Okay. Is it okay, children? Anjita?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, what happened, Arjun? Is it clear? Is it okay, Arjun? Afsana? Is it okay? Children, please turn on your video. Every day I'm repeatedly
mentioning
this. Yes, Savio?
Can you show the board one more time? You had not shared the screen.
Okay. Okay. Now look at the next question. Okay. So the next question is, I think it is the 8th question. Yesterday's children, when I am sending the questions, you note the question number also. Okay. I'm sending the questions from the NCERT. Okay. Now look at this question. This is the 8th question. Okay. A is a point on the side. Can you read this? Can you say this one, Aditya? Adidev?
No, ma'am.
No.
Ma'am, it's not clear.
Now, is it okay?
Yes. B is a point on the side AB produced of a parallelogram ABCD and BE intercept CD at head. So that triangle ABE is similar to triangle CFD.
Similar to triangle CFD. Okay. E is a point on the side AD produced of a parallelogram ABCD and BE intersects CD at F. Show that ABE is similar to triangle CFB. ABE is similar to triangle CFB. Okay. Okay. Listen. So here figure is not given. We have to draw the figure. What is given here? E is a point on the side AD produced of a parallelogram. So we need to draw one parallelogram. Okay. So I'm drawing one parallelogram. We know that in a parallelogram, opposite sides are
parallel.
Parallel. And in a parallelogram, opposite sides are parallel.
Ma'am, will you show the slide one more time?
You copied that question or not, Rifa?
Ma'am, I was not home yesterday.
Okay. See, children, whenever I send the questions, please copy it. Okay. Okay. What are the properties of a parallelogram? Opposite sides are parallel and equal. Then what about opposite angles? Opposite angles are equal. What about adjacent angles? Adjacent angles are supplementary. Adjacent angles are supplementary. What about the diagonals? Diagonals of a parallelogram, are they equal?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Tomorrow, find it out and come. Okay. Check. Okay. Find it out and come. In a parallelogram, whether the diagonals are equal. Okay. We have learned about so many quadrilaterals: square, rectangle, rhombus, trapezium, parallelogram. So in which of these quadrilaterals the diagonals will be equal? In which of these quadrilaterals the diagonals will be equal? Okay, we need all those things while proving this congruency. Okay, in which all the cases diagonals equal? In which all the cases diagonals bisect each other? In parallelograms, whether the diagonals bisect each other? Okay, find it out. Okay, tomorrow I'll be asking these questions. Diagonals, whether they will bisect, whether the diagonals are equal. Not only that, in which quadrilaterals and all diagonals bisect each other at right angles?
Rhombus.
Yes? Rhombus. Okay, rhombus, correct. Is it only in rhombus? Is there any other quadrilateral? Okay, find out. All these properties we need. We need the properties of quadrilaterals. Okay? Learn all the properties of, write down this, children, these five quadrilaterals: trapezium, square, rectangle, parallelogram, rhombus. Okay? These five quadrilaterals, we want to learn whether the diagonals are equal, whether the diagonals bisect each other, in which cases and all diagonals are perpendicular bisectors. This thing, you find it out and come. Okay. Now look at this question. Look at this question, children. It is given ABCD is a parallelogram. When we name the parallelogram, children, A, B, don't jump here. When we jump here, the everything proof we will not get. Okay, when we name a quadrilateral, you name it in an order. Either we should move clockwise or anti-clockwise. A, B, here only I'm naming this as C, then D. E is a point on the side AD produced. What is meant by AD? Produced. AD produced means? We are extending AD, isn't it? AD is produced. So we can extend here or we can extend upwards. Both the cases we can try. Okay. Suppose I am extending it upwards. Suppose I am extending here AD. Okay. It is not given. Is it up or down? For the exam, it will not be given. We have to try this, isn't it? So look at here. E is a point on the side AD. Suppose I am extending it up. Now what is given? BE intersects CD. E is a point. E is the point extended. Now what is given? BE should intersect CD. If I join BE, will it intersect CD here?
No, ma'am.
It will not intersect. Is it clear? Hmm? So therefore, no need to extend on the top. So what do you have to do? We will extend it here. Suppose E is here. Now join BE. Whether BE will intersect CD, name this as F. So this is the figure given. E is the point on the side AD produced of a parallelogram ABCD, which intersects BE and CD at F. BE and CD intersect at F. We have to prove triangle ABE is similar to triangle CFB. We can easily prove this, children. We can prove this easily. So look at this. Which are the two triangles you have to prove as similar? I shade this triangle so you can identify. You can tell me. We have three criteria for proving similar. We have to prove ABE, this triangle, is similar to CFB. Is similar to CFB. CFB. So this is the triangle. Okay. We have three criteria. AA criteria, SAS, SSS. If you get two angles equal, I'll give a clue. If you prove two angles equal, you'll get the results. Isn't it? By AA criteria, it will become similar.
Yes, ma'am.
We have to prove two angles equal. Find out. Yes, repeat it. A and C. Okay. Angle 1 equals angle 2. I name this as 1 and 2. Okay. Then.
Angle DFB.
AB is equal to C.
AB is equal to? Yes, repeat it, Savio.
Not me, ma'am.
And then?
BC equal.
BC equals?
B is not equal, is common.
B. B we can't, okay, B as a whole we can't take, isn't it?
Vertically opposite angles.
But here, this is the full triangle. Okay, this big triangle. Okay, I'll shade it with another color. I think
angle
the color.
Angle B is common.
Angle B is it common? Look at here. Only this triangle we have. One triangle I'm shading with a purple color, this color. Another triangle is in brown color. Angle 1 equals angle 2, it is okay. What about the other one?
Half of angle B.
Half of angle B.
Is equal to.
E. E. How? How? Oh, yeah, what you are giving is correct. Mm. How? It is not linear pair. Listen here, children. Here, this angle.
5, 6.
Okay, suppose I name this as 3. Angle 3 will be equal to angle 4. Why?
Alternate interior angles.
Very good. Alternate interior angles. Alternate interior angles, because these two are parallel lines and this is a transversal. Okay, so it is given ABCD is a parallelogram. We are using the properties of parallelogram. So which two triangles we want to prove as similar? You consider the triangle ABE and triangle BCF. In these two triangles, we have angle 1 is angle 2. The reason is opposite angles of a parallelogram. Opposite angles of a parallelogram are equal. Angle 3 equals angle 4. What is the reason? Alternate interior angles. Now we have two angles as equal. Two angles are equal. Therefore, which criteria we can use? By AA criteria. Two angles enough, isn't it? So by AA criteria, triangle A B E will be similar to triangle CFB. A B E will be similar to triangle CFB. So this question is a repeated question. This parallelogram question is a repeated question. In order to prove similar, you check whether two angles are equal. If you get two angles are equal, we will be able to prove the result easily.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, this is an important question. Mark it in your notebook. This is an important question. We use the properties of parallelogram. Try this question again. Okay. Do the same questions, which are the questions we are discussing in the class. The same question, do it again as homework. Is it okay, children? Rosebi? Lolita?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Rifa? Is it okay, Rifa? Hmm?
Yes, ma'am, I am writing.
Ah, okay. Okay. Okay, children. Is it okay? Now, let's do the next one. Next question. Okay. Look at this question. I think this is a lengthy one. We'll not be able to complete. Look at this question. In the given figure, okay, so in the given figure, ABC and AMP are two right triangles. In the given figure, AMP and ABC are two right triangles, right angled at B and M respectively. Okay, we have two right triangles. ABC is one right angle triangle. And the other triangle is, right angle triangle is AMP. AMP is one right angle triangle. And ABC is the another right angle triangle. We have to prove ABC is similar to triangle AMP. Can you prove this?
Should we prove it just one, Gurat?
Yes.
So first angle will be... Two right angles.
Let's repeat it. See here, some audio problem is there. Repeat it. Who is giving
the answer? Two right angles.
Two right angles. We have to prove two angles as equal, isn't it? This is one triangle. AMP is one triangle, and ABC is another triangle. Okay. Yes.
Angle is common.
Very good. Angle A is common. Yes. Angle A is common. Is it present in both the triangles? You check it.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes or no? It is present in both the triangles. Then One more angle, can you prove it is equal? What is given?
Angle M.
Angle M is equal to
90 degrees.
Angle M is equal to angle B is equal to 90 degrees. It is given. Yes or no? It is given in the question. It is given. They are right angles. So we consider two triangles here. Which are the two triangles? In triangle ABC and triangle AMP. In these two triangles, angle A is common. And angle B is equal to angle M is equal to 90 degree. Therefore, which criteria we can use here, Vishnu? Which criteria we can use? Which is the which criteria we can use here? Yes? Which criteria you can use here? Only two angles. Then AA criteria. When two angles means it is AA. So by AA criteria, we can write the first result. Triangle ABC is similar to triangle AMP. ABC will be similar to triangle AMP. Two angles are equal. If two angles are equal, we can use AA criteria. Therefore, triangle ABC is similar to triangle AMP. What about the second result? Yes.
CA divided by M.
CA by PA is equal to BC by MP. How? And Mary, how will you get the CA by PA is equal to BC?
Common angle.
Is it common angle? These two triangles are similar. If two triangles are similar, what you can say?
Sides are.
Sides are.
Proportional.
Yes. Yes, children. Hey, Steve, is it okay?
Yes, ma'am.
These two triangles are similar. Therefore, corresponding sides are proportional. Therefore, what we will get? AB by AM is equal to BC by MP is equal to AC by AB. I'm taking the first two letters. AB by AM equal to BC by MP is equal to AC by AB. Now look at the result. Which one you want? I think the last two ratios only you need, isn't it? Is it the last two ratios? Look at here. CA by PA is equal to BC by MP. Therefore, okay, which how it is asked in the question, in the same way you can write. Therefore, CA by PA is equal to BC by MP. Therefore, Roman letter 2 is also proved. Here we have proved the first one. Roman letter 1 is proved. Now we have proved the Roman letter 2. Okay, if two triangles are similar, corresponding sides are proportional. So from the proportional, yes, what is the condition needed? We write only those condition. Okay. Is it okay? Yes, now, who is ready with the seminar? Arshik, get ready.
Yes, ma'am.
You all completed this one, children? You all copied?
Yes, ma'am.
No, copy it first. Copy this. Arshik, get ready. Okay. Okay, Arshik, get ready, Arshik. Yes, you can start.
Can you see the screen, ma'am?
Ah, yes. What about your children? Can you see? Aditya?
Sir?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
So, good afternoon, everyone. I am Ashish Patel of class 10. We have to present Max activity on my Max topic and start of an activity. So, in this seminar, I would like to discuss three things. Those three things are arithmetic progressions. So in the arithmetic progressions, we will discuss about what is arithmetic progression. In the second place, we will discuss the general form of arithmetic progressions. And in the third thing, as usual, my topic, nth term of an AP. So first one, arithmetic progression. Can anyone say what is arithmetic progression? Rifa, can you say what is arithmetic progression?
A series in which there are terms and the difference between a term and its preceding term is equal, or which is a constant.
Your answer is correct. Arithmetic progression, a sequence of numbers that has a common difference between any two consecutive numbers, is called an arithmetic progression, or it is shortly denoted by AP. In arithmetic progression, there will be a constant difference. It can change according to the equation, but if only a constant difference is there, we can identify or prove it as an arithmetic progression. So next one, I would like to discuss the general form of an AP. The general form of an arithmetic progression is A plus D, A plus 2D, A plus 3D, and so on. When we do an arithmetic progression, it is always infinity. It does not have an end. If it comes as odd or even numbers in the given question, only then there is an limit. Otherwise, it is infinity. So the general form is that An is equal to A plus n minus 1 into D, in which A is the first term of the AP and n is the number of terms minus 1 into D. D is the common difference. So I think that everybody understands this concept. Is it clear? So this I would like to share a quote with you. I would have gone far in any science because on the path of every science, the line in mathematics is straightforward. It is by C.S. Lewis in his book, Surprised of Joy, The Shape of My Life, The Shape of My Early Life. So the third term is term of an AP. It's number of terms. So anybody can say that what is nth term of an AP? Rose, can you say what is the nth term of an AP? Okay. Nth term of it. Nth term of an AP. The nth term of an AP is A is equal to A plus N minus 1 into D, as well as we saw earlier. So I would like to share a question with you, I need your help to solve this question. The question is that if the nth term of an AP is 9, of an AP 9, 7, 5, infinitely, is the same as the nth term of an AP 15, according to that. So first one, let the first term of an AP and its common difference is D. So A is the nth term of the AP and the common difference is denoted by D, and the constant term is N. According to the formula of AP, so we all know that the formula of AP is An is equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. So AP is equal, the arithmetic progression is that 9, 7 and 5 there on. So in this one, we can see that the difference is two, and the first first part the first term is 9. So when we equate this, when we substitute this in that equation of an AP for nth term, we will get that an is equal to 9 plus n minus 1 into negative d, negative 2. An, we got negative 2 because 9, 7 and 5 is an arithmetic progression in which the rate is decreasing. So as the rate is decreasing in the arithmetic progression, so the common difference is decreasing in the arithmetic progression, the common difference will be negative, and if the arithmetic progression is increasing, the common difference will be positive. So when we substitute that, we will get an is equal to 9 plus n minus 1 into 2. That is, an is equal to a plus n minus 1 into b. So in that, an is equal to, we bring the 2 to the next side and substitute. So negative 2n plus 11, negative 2n plus 11. Now the second AP of the second equation. So 15, 12 and 9. In this equation 2, it is a decreasing equation. So we will have a common difference as negative 3. So AP formula, I think that you understand. So the first term of this AP is 15 and the common difference is negative 3. So when we do, when we calculate this formula, we will get that an is equal to 15 plus n minus 1 into negative 3. So an is equal to negative 3. As we done before, we will change the places. So negative 3n plus 18 is the second equation. So we have equation 1 equals to equation 2 because n, both are AP, and AP is and because the nth term of the AP is equal. From equation 1 and 2, we get T1 is equal to T2. Term 1 is equal to term 2. So negative 2n plus 11 is equal to negative 3n plus 18. And negative 2n plus 3n is equal to negative, is equal to 18 minus 17. So n is equal to 7. So hence in this equation, we will get that n is equal to 7. So in this seminar, we discussed that 50% of arithmetic progressions. So I think that everybody understand what is arithmetic progressions, the concept of arithmetic progression. Arithmetic progression is also known as arithmetic sequence. And 30% of general term of an AP. General term that general term and AN is the same. 20% nth term of an AP. That was my topic. So there is a bonus slide for you. The person who discovered arithmetic progression is the, or invented arithmetic progression is the, John Carl Friedrich Gauss. He was a French mathematician. Once he was in 7th grade, his class teacher asked him to sum up the numbers from 1 to 10, the even or odd numbers from 1 to 10. At the time, standard 7, he found out this formula, and it was later released in his older age. So this is the original note or original printed note of arithmetic progression, and it contains all the sequences. A quote by John Carl Friedrich Gauss: mathematics is a cure of science. Thank you.
Ashik?
Yes, sir.
Very good. Okay. You did it well. Okay, very good. You included so many points. Is there no children? Huh? Very okay. Okay, he included many quotes and all. Okay, Ashik, well done. Okay, thank you, children.